described and captioned media program in the classroom and online. DCMP.org.
Human Relations Media presents Diabetes. Why many teens are at risk.
I was diagnosed almost 2 years ago.
I found out 2 months ago.
I was in first grade when I got diabetes.
I was diagnosed at 10 years old.
I was 12.
I was scared.
I thought I'd done something wrong.
I didn't know anyone who had it.
I was like really nervous. I was like, what's diabetes? Am I gonna die?
The title appears, Diabetes, Why Many Teens Are at Risk.
Amanda is 22 years old and just out of college.
I have a family of four, myself, my father, my mom, and my sister.
Richard is 14 and about to go into eighth grade.
I have a mom, a dad, and a sister.
Dee is 17.
I've been adopted for about 2.5 years. I'm gonna be a senior this year.
15-year-old Cody is a sophomore in high school.
I love to sing, dance, and play the piano.
Thomas is 17.
I'm gonna be a senior in high school.
Crystal is 15.
Gonna be a sophomore, I'm kinda excited.
Six fairly typical young people, except for one thing. Every one of them either has diabetes or is at risk of contracting it.
Dr. Susan Ratson.
Diabetes is a condition of insulin insufficiency. Either your body doesn't make any insulin, or your body makes insulin, sometimes even excessive insulin, but the insulin doesn't work well.
Insulin is a hormone made in the pancreas that allows your body to use sugar or glucose as an energy source. Some glucose is produced by our bodies. The remaining glucose is produced from the sugar in the food we eat, mainly from carbohydrates like bread, milk, fruit, and sweets. When people do not have diabetes, insulin regulates the sugar in their bodies. It's almost as if insulin is a key.
Insulin being that key to allow blood glucose to get into the cells. Without insulin, your blood glucose or blood sugar can't get into the cells, so it's just sort of trapped in the bloodstream. You need glucose to run all of the machinery of your cells to help your heart beat, your lungs breathe, and without glucose, none of those things can happen very efficiently.
Left untreated, the long-term complications of diabetes can be devastating.
Small blood vessel disease, decreased vision and blindness. It can cause kidney damage, nerve damage, and it can also cause large blood vessel disease, such as blocking of the arteries to the heart muscle, which can lead to heart attack.
Kids walk outdoors.
The two main kinds of diabetes that affect young people are called type 1 and type 2 diabetes.
Now D.
The physicians figured out that I had type 2.
Crystal.
I have type 2 diabetes and I was diagnosed 5 years ago.
Definition.
In type 2 diabetes, the body still makes insulin.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approval list of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.